Hi guys, my name is Harvansh and first of all, thanks for watching my other videos about the series Semantic and the SCCM. So I got a feedback like I have directly started installation of SCCM sites and SQL. So I have not explained about how you can build your lab. So here is, I'm gonna start this series about the prerequisites. Already I created 3-4 videos like how you can install your SQL server in your VM and how you can build your lab for the testing purpose. Okay guys, so here is, I'm gonna start this video about to how you can install the prerequisite for the SCCM installation. Okay guys, so let me show you the another video, slides. So here is like a common prerequisite. So first I will explain you like when we are installing SCCM, what the prerequisite is, the compulsory required. So here is the first prerequisite, SQL Server 2012 or the higher the version. So there is a so many SCCM versions are running in the market like 1511, 1602, 1606, then 17 series, then 18 series, and now we are on the 19. After that also 20 series also came. So it's a totally depend about the which version you are installing. Based on that SCCM version, your prerequisite will change. So here I mention like the more detail, check in the description. So I will paste the prerequisite link from the Microsoft, which OS version you needed to install your SCCM. So guys, just check the description where there you find out the which OS version is required for the which SCCM version. Okay guys, so next point is the minimum 100 GB hard disk. So why I have mentioned it's like for the lab purpose, because you're gonna install your SQL server and AD server and then the SCCM server ADK. So there are the so many things needs to be installed to running your SCCM infra in the lab. So minimum at least you required like a 100 GB. If you are not giving the 100 GB, it's it will be causing an issue like a disk space issue. Even though it's not like a 100 GB only, 80 GB also you can use it, or more than it also you can use. So this is a requirement for your lab purpose. And if you're gonna install your SCCM in the production, so guys, first go through the Microsoft site and check the what the size is required. So there's the size scalability is there, where you can measure how many clients are there and which how much the site is required. So you can check it, the client, it's the depend on the client counts. Okay, so here is a minimum 8 GB RAM. Yes, I have mentioned it's for the lab purpose, minimum 8 GB RAM. But if you wanna run your SCCM in the production, 8 GB is not enough. At least 16 GB you should required. So it's again totally depend where you're gonna install your SQL database. It will be on the same server or it would be on the different server. So it's again like a depend on the client counts, because client will report and the size SCCM database size will be huge. So it's totally depend on that. So guys, 4 GB also you can use in your lab. So but it will be like a bit slow, so you are unable to work properly. So better to give the 6 or the 8 GB. I have assigned the 8 GB RAM in my server and it's working fine for me. Then the next prerequisite is the service account with admin rights. Okay, so to be install your SCCM, your machine should be having one account, like your that account will call like a service account for the SCCM. It should be having like a total admin rights, and it should be created for the especially for your SCCM to install the SCCM. And here I forgot to add one more thing is machine server should be added on domain. Okay, so you need the one service account with the admin rights to install SCCM and run the SCCM. That account will use everywhere, like the client post to manage SCCM, login the SCCM, and to be install the SCCM also. So one service account should be needed, so be ready with that. And another thing is server should be added on the domain. So when you are installing, start installing your SSCM. So before that, there is so many prerequisites should be there before you start building your lab. So just check out your server version and the size, how much hard disk size is there, RAM, and the service account you should have. So to creating service account in a lab, I saw one more video is like in how to install the AD and how you can create the account. So you can check my other videos about the prerequisite. So this is we was in the topic, server should be added in the domain. If your machine not in the domain and you just login with the locally account, local admin account or any other account, guys, it not be allowed to install the setup because it's need a domain account. Now it's a like a SQL server. So this is the main prerequisite because SCCM gonna use the SQL database server, and it should be like the minimum 2k12 and the higher version. Again, it's a depend like which SCCM version you're gonna use it. So based on that, SQL version will be changed. So I install in my server like 16.06 and I use 2k16 SQL server, but again it's a SQL version will be changed which SCCM version you're gonna use it. So SQL version or the higher for cache site like a central administrative site. If you wanna install the cache server, obviously you need a one SQL there. And if you wanna install like a standalone site, okay, you need separate server for the standalone. So these are the two types info like cache and the install standalone. So you need the SQL database for that. And if you're gonna install it, primary site installation. So if you wanna install your primary site, yes, you need a SQL database server separately for these site. So again, it up to you which kind of infra you wanna build it. I'm giving you just the common prerequisite, basic things, very basic things to build your lab. And when you are into the production, guys, go through the Microsoft article where he mentioned like OS detail and the hardware detail, going through it thoroughly and then plan it. And now it's a next prerequisite, Active Directory schema extend any of the first site installation. Okay, so what is this Active Directory schema extend? I will show you in the lab now all the things what I'm talking you. So it will be like a Active Directory schema should be there. If you want to install your SCCM server, yes, obviously this system management folder will create and then will give in the rights. So when your SCCM server will install, it will create the site code details and the np detail under your AD under the system management folder. So these are the common things. And this Active Directory schema, so Active Directory schema extend any of the first site installation. So why I mention this sentence is like I'm gonna use the cache concept, and I have a one cache server and 2-3 primaries. So for other primaries, no need to extend the schema. It's a one-time job. In the AD you have to extend, and all the other sites will use the same schema. Okay, so other prerequisite is like .NET 4.5. again, it's like which version you are gonna use it. So maybe it will goes to 4.5.2 and it can be the 4.8 and the other .NET as well. So which version? 16.06, it require 4.5. And when you're gonna install your SCCM, just check it which version you are using. So check the .NET compatibility and download and install the before starting installation. For any site like the cache, standalone, primary, you need the .NET. It's a compulsory. Okay, again, it's a ADK installation for the first site installation. So whichever link you required, I will put it in my description, all the links necessary like the hardware capacity, software capacity, and where you will download the SQL, where you will download the server, where you gonna download your .NET, and where you gonna download the ADK. Okay, so these are the basic prerequisites which we needed. Might be I have missed any out, so you can just comment me and let me know. I will add it again. So let's move it to the our server, and I will show you how you can do it. So there is a other prerequisite also there, and like bits and other things, so no need to worry and no need to remember it. We have a tool ready there which we can use it, and easily my all the prerequisite will installed. Okay, so let's move it to the my server. Okay, so here is my server, and here I have copied just few things which are really needed. Okay, so first what I will show you, let's see the one by one, and here I can make a note which are the things I am going to use. Notepad, first thing what I will do it, I will create a account, create service account. So how you gonna create it? Open your dsa.msc. I saw in my last video how you can install your Active Directory. Okay, so once you created your Active Directory, and then you can go to the users, and here already I have created the SCCM, but I can show you how you can create the account. Even my the other video you can see in it how you can create a account. So first thing, right click here, I'll show you again, users, here you go to the new and the users, and here I will give SCCM admin, because already I'm using SCCM account, SCCM admin. Okay guys, so this is my account created, and now it's asking for the password. As it is a service account, so no need to change on the next logon, and password never expire. If you have not selected this option, it will expire after the 45 days, and based on your AD policies. So again, you have to reset it, and this is gonna create a problem. So service account is something like password should not be expired never ever. So I am clicking password never expired. Okay, fine. So this is done. So I have done my account creation is done. Now second thing is, I need to check whether my account is having proper rights or not. Okay, so I will make this account member of, now it's a domain user. Okay, now I have to make it like a domain admin. So here you can see in it. So if I'm making it a domain admins, and my this account will work like a domain administrator on the any machine. If this user is gonna try to access something, it should be having the full admin rights. So this is the rights I provided to my user account, and service account rights. Okay, so I have given proper rights to my service account. Now the third point is gonna give to I will go to in that administrator, sorry, I am in AD. So here is my administrators. Okay, so this right is more than enough, and but if we are using one more machine, so there locally you have to add your account to install your any site role if you wanna remotely deploy. So user prerequisite is done. I can show you in the another my one more machine I have. So how you can see that, so if you are going to install any role on different site like DP and MP, so I am not talking about the SCCM installation. So SCCM will install on the same machine, it's not gonna create any problem. So how you will see that, not here, this is also one more AD. I can go in my the SCCM server, another already I am having my SCCM info. So let me leave this and let me go to the computer management. So here is the group and my machine should be part of the administrator. Okay, so here my machine that whatever I have the SCCM words wise it should be added. Like if I am having SCCM server in this side, so that secondary side DP side or the MP what I'm gonna install on that remote site, it should be added here, and the same hostname username it should be added the another side. So that's I wanna explain it here. Okay, so here is the local admin rights, local admin rights on a remote machine. Okay, so this part is done. Now it is like a fourth point. So first we'll install the .NET installation installation. So let's start the .NET installation. .NET link I will give it to you from where you can download. So I downloaded offline installation. So you just double click and yes. And this file I will save it, because if the machine rebooted, my data will be lost. So here is SCCM prerequisite. So now what I'm doing, I am installing the .NET, and I will show you how it will going to install. After this we will install the ADK, and then the other things will do it. So let's see how much time it will take. It's not gonna take more and much time. So these all the prerequisites should be in place before you going to start your installation. So SQL installation we will be taking in the last, and I have created a separate video how you can install your SQL database server. So apart from that SQL database server, I will show you here. Okay, so let me close it. Asking for something is opening. Okay, yes, no problem. Now already I closed, and guys, it will take some time, at least 5-10 minutes. So let me pause this video. Okay guys, so my .NET installation is done, and now can I click on finish. Basically when you are installing the .NET, you should be reboot your machine, so it will be applied completely. So let me go to the CMD just I'm doing the force boot. Shit, something goes wrong. SHUTDOWN. Okay, so let me reboot this machine, then we'll start installation for ADK. Okay guys, so I have rebooted my machine, and now we back to install the next prerequisite. So now we can go to our, let me open this. And this machine is done, this is done, and now I'm going to, this is done. Now fifth is what I'm going to do, ADK installation, ADK honest installation. Okay, so let me check ADK. Okay, so this is something else is open. Let me go to the prerequisite folder where I downloaded my softwares. Here sit software, and here is the ADK. So ADK you need to download based on what you're gonna do it. Okay, So, like you want to install SCCM 1606, 1602, or the other thing. So, based on your requirement, you can download your ADK. So, I downloaded ADK for the Windows 10. Click on next, yes, and accept the license. Okay, so here all the things are not required, and so here the only the few things are required, which we will select and which we will start installing. Okay guys, so here is so many prerequisites. These are the ADK part. So what we needed, we don't want like ACT deployment tool. Yes, we can need it. Windows PE, yes, we need it. Imaging and ICT is not required. User state migration, yes, it required. VAT is not required, and Windows performance toolkit. So these are things are not at all required. So you no need to install other features. Only the three things are required: Windows deployment tool, install WinPE, and the USMT. So USMT and so these two three things are required: deployment tool and the WinPE and the USMT. Okay, so you can just select it and click on the start installation, click yes, and it's going to start installation. And after this installation, we will check the other prerequisites. So I can mention it like ADK installation is going to done. Okay, so let me check. Okay, let it installed. I will pause this video so we can resume it from there, or else it will be like very lengthy video, I guess. Okay, so the installation got completed. Let me close it. And this ADK installation also done. And now what is that is will create the system management folder under AD system system management management group in AD. Actually it's a system management container, so I can mention like a group. I will show you how to create it in AD. Okay, so for this I need to open AD SI edit. So under AD SI edit will create our software management folder under the ADSIEDIT under ADSIT. Okay, so how it gonna work? It's now it is open. Right click and connect to. Okay, just click OK. And here is the system folder. Under this I will create my system management folder. Okay, so still it not created. Now create new object, and here will be the container. Okay, so select the container given the system system ma system management. Okay, click next, finish. Now on this system management I need the complete rights to extend the our AD schema. So go to the go to security, click OK, and here type your account. So check account SCCM. Okay, and give it the full rights. And one more thing you have to do, in this dsa.msc your account should be like admin schema, or else it not going to extend your AD schema. So admin schema is here and you should be the member of it. So already I am member of it like a schema admin. Okay guys, so this is AD system container. It's created, it's done. Now we'll go for the six. Extend extend AD SCHEMA AD schema. Okay, so now I will show you the one tool which already I downloaded, and no need to suffer about like which prerequisite you have to install and which is not, and maybe you are struggling a lot and sometime you missed out that. So better to download this tool. I will giving you the description, this tool detail in the description. So let me go and show to you how this tool gonna work it. So this tool is developed by one of the great man. His name I forgot. I will show you that his name and the detail. I will share his the blogs list. Okay, so let's see. So this tool will extend the AD schema, and the it will install other thing also. So unsupported platform detect recommended to the application in the domain controller. No problem. It's like I'm going to extend the schema. So now Active Directory, and it's detect. Okay, now it's the lab.harvansh.com. It's browse, and here my setup should be there. Okay, 1 minute. Okay guys, so let me click on browse, and let me go to the my setup. I have copied my setup here, and it's like the under setup, and I'm searching the which file is used for the extending the AD schema. So this file is will be here, that called like extend schema SCH. So just select this and click on stage and now click on the extend. So it will extend your AD schema, and it will be like no need to do the any manual things are here. So now successfully AD schema for the configuration manager it extend. Okay, so let me check where it got extend. We can go to the logs file, and it will be here AD schema extend, and you can see in it like okay. So now extended. So although the AD schema now be the extended, so now my the AD schema extended, and what it added in the AD schema, so you can see in here the list. If you want to go something in deep dive, so you can learn these many things also. Okay, so one part is done, and now I can mention okay, this is done, and now is the time for installation. What is 6 it was, now it is 7, and now it is 8. So AD schema extension done. Now I am installing sites. Okay, so site feature, what I'm going to select it here, go to the sites, and which I am going to install it like a primary, central, and the secondary. Okay, so primary is also like a standalone site, both are having the same prerequisite here, primary primary site prerequisites. So now I am going to start primary. If you want to install prerequisite for cache, okay, so you can select it, and if you wanna install the secondary site, you can select it here, and the same way you can use the site role also. If you want to install MP, DP, application catalog, you can select it here. It's a very useful app. So guys, download it, and the human error will not happen. So I'm going to start prerequisite for the primary site. Select it and start, click on installation. So it will install one by one. There is a 9 features be required to install here on the primary. So here it's gonna install its .NET framework 4.5 features. Anyway, we installed, but it will verify all the things, all the prerequisites. So let it installed, no need to do anything when it's getting installed. After this installation, SQL database will be remaining, and for the SQL database I created one separate video. You can go through my the this SCCM playlist, and there you can find out the how to install the SQL database for SCCM sites. So after these prerequisite completion, you can install your SQL database, and then the next video is available there already. So how you can install your SCCM, and then the other video are there, like the secondary site, DP, MP, and the other videos. If you need any other videos, like specific videos, let me know. I will create it for you. So let it install. And after this installation, we all good, and there will not be any prerequisite pending. So I am pausing this video, guys, so it will not consume your time, and I will back if there is any error or it's got successfully completed. Guys, so now this all the features are installed successfully, and now I can click on continue. So all the features you can see, like this is no need changes, and other thing is no need any change, whatever is mentioned, like no need any change, that means it's already installed. So now we good to go with the primary site or the standalone site installation. Okay guys, so this is done, and hope you learn something about how you can build your lab setup. So in this video, everything is there, and if you face any trouble, just comment me on my video. I can able to answer you if something is not working or something is missed out. Okay guys, so thank you for watching this video, and keep continue my video, keep watching my videos, and for this next video, SQL videos is there. You can search out in my playlist and listen that carefully and build your lab there. Okay guys, so thank you for watching this video. See you soon in my next video.